Hey, what's up, everybody? Welcome to a whole new series of Digibros.
Holy shit, we're in outer space.
Yes.
There must be a beginning of any great matter.
All right, enough of that.
But the continuing unto the end.
Stop, you sound terrible. Welcome to Uncharted 1. We're going to play Uncharted. We've decided that the way we're going to do this, because this game's pretty easy.
A little bit.
You know, I was going to play this. Victor doesn't really want to watch me play this because he, I guess, is, like, sick of the, like, to his stomach of the idea that he would watch someone play video games.
I'm impatient.
Even though everyone watches him play video games all the time.
Yeah, but I don't watch Let's Plays. I listen to Let's Plays.
So, Victor didn't want to watch me play this, and I was like, well, what if we switched off every time one of us dies? But this game is so easy that there's no way that would happen unless we ratcheted up the difficulty.
Ratchet as fuck.
So this game's difficulty levels go Explorer, Easy, Normal, Hard, Very Hard, Brutal, and then there was an unlockable one called... This was Crushing.
It went Hard, Crushing, and then there's, like, Nightmare or something.
Yeah, so we put it on Crushing. This should be Very Hard.
It should crush us. Don't know how long we'll last at Crushing.
We're gonna alternate between us each time one of us dies.
So is this like a full, like, texture HD remake kind of thing, or is it like...
It definitely looks...
Because this looks pretty nice.
Yeah, this looks nice.
Like it holds up a lot better than I thought it would. Because I saw some footage of it in someone's analysis video, and I was just like, man, this game looks really dated, and now it doesn't look as dated as I remembered it looking at that.
Well, this is the HD collection.
Like, so. I do remember it being beautiful. It's weird when you say HD collection with a game like Uncharted that was always HD. Like,
but were the textures HD? Was the game HD?
Because the PS3 was a... Yeah, but the PS3 came with an HDMI port no matter what. It was HD.
Was it like 480p or like, was it 10?
Yeah, I guess that's a good question.
Like, how many PS3 games actually went up to 1080p?
Yeah, it might have been 720.
So
it could be improved.
Yeah.
Now it's in 4K. All the Ks, there's just like
several.
Do you
think it's in 4K? That'd be crazy.
One more than triple K.
So, yeah, this scene is like, this girl's a reporter, and Nathan Drake's a thief, but she's cutie.
No. She has that generic, like, girl in an Adam Sandler movie look to her. She's like so generically blonde.
You just mean Jennifer Aniston.
Yes. She's blonde and tanned and absolutely generic. Not that Nathan Drake isn't the most generic-looking guy of all time. They're just like, how do we pick the most generic-looking white people imaginable?
Yeah, that's why
absolutely, like, Barbie Ken doll, like, nothing people.
Well, I died,
wow, that was
so
fast. All right. Crushing.
I didn't take cover, so I died.
How do I take cover?
I was trying to get used to the controls.
Okay.
Circle.
Ammo.
Oh
shit, there's pirates.
So yeah, our buddy Hippocrit, who is a games reviewer on YouTube, if you haven't watched his videos, you should. He's really great. He hates Uncharted.
Aww.
Because he hates that whole console generation because of what it did to
his favorite
developers.
It's not as goofy and like,
it's
animals.
Funny. Right, we went through the same thing that he did, where we were really into, like,
goofy games with animals.
Well, we were really into, like, Ratchet and Clank, especially.
Yeah, Ratchet and Clank was awesome.
And then Ratchet and Clank was Insomniac, and they went on to make Resistance Fall of Man, which is a game that's like
very gritty.
Like a gritty war game starring a bald white guy, right?
Yeah.
So they went from, like, a raccoon thing. What the hell was Ratchet? What was he supposed to be?
He's
like
a Lombax.
A Lombax, right.
He is not any sort of forest critter that is out of this world.
It was a game about a Lombax and a tiny metal, like, robot thing, you know, and then they made a World War II first-person shooter about a white guy, right? So then you got Jack and Daxter.
Not really World War II. I mean, it's still a pretty ridiculous sci-fi game. No, it's not.
Wasn't it set it's during one of the World Wars.
It's like...
It's an alternate universe version of one of the World Wars.
It's an alternate universe where mole men came out of the ground and started attacking. Yeah, World War II.
But it did take place during World War II.
I think it's sort of like around that timeline. But it's not like Hitler's there or anything.
It was like the Reich got transformed into like...
No.
Aliens type thing, wasn't it?
Like, no.
Aliens invaded during the... I definitely remember
Dude,
it being
I played
a World
all
War
three
game.
Games. Like, it's not a World War anything game.
I'm pretty sure it's set during that time period. It's during
It borrowed the aesthetic of that time period.
It is during a war, though. Like, okay. A real war. It is during a real historical... Someone is gonna... We're gonna get a million comments about this.
I don't know anybody played Resistance. I probably know more than anyone.
dude, someone's played every game we've talked about on this show. You know? We did Phantasy Star Online Let's Plays and got people bitching about our Phantasy Star Online play on this. So, we definitely...
Shit, dude.
There's a, I think there's
this fucking turret is killing me.
Behind that, behind the turret.
Behind the turret. Oh, I think I'm just waiting for Sully to like save my ass.
Yeah, Sully.
Sully's a cool name.
You keep saying it like with an O.
Oh, I was thinking of it like the monster from Monsters Inc.
It is the same. They're both spelled with a U, not
Sully.
An O.
Monsters University was a good movie. I thought it was
that
a
was
good
random?
Sequel.
Okay. Anyways, congratulations on getting us off the boat.
Hell yeah, we're off the boat.
So, anyway, what the fuck was I talking about? Yeah, Naughty Dog. They made a game that was about a dude who's like a weird furry guy.
He's also a Lombax.
Is he also a Lombax?
In my opinion.
A weird furry guy with his little, like, you know, animal sidekick, and they're doing like a platforming adventure. And then they made Uncharted, which is a shooting game about a white guy. And then you had, what's it called? The third one, Sucker Punch. Who made Sucker Punch? Oh, yeah. Who made Sly Cooper about
what,
a bunch of talking animals?
What have they done after? Are they just
they
gone?
They did Infamous.
Like... Oh yeah!
They did all the Infamous games about a bald white guy.
Yeah, about a bald white guy with superpowers.
So Give and Take Hypocrite rather really hates that whole generation because of like he.
I
was...
would say the Infamous games went the grittiest route. Like Uncharted is still like whimsical and like goes for this like.
Fun,
you know,
cool.
Fun action movie Indiana Jones feel to it.
Right.
And then, like, the Resistance games really did have more interesting elements in them if you play through them, but it's,
right.
like, from the surface, they look like
they're
just
very gray,
Halo.
Though.
They're very great, but then the deeper you get into the games, the more it starts to deviate from that, and,
right.
like, it still has the ridiculous weapons of Ratchet and Clank.
Yeah, the weapons that, like, are definitely the coolest thing about them.
The first one definitely had some interesting senses to it, and then the second one actually had a... Like, I remember the plot being pretty cool, and then the third one just totally becomes,
Holy
like, an 80s
shit,
action
great.
Movie kind of thing
right.
to it. Where, like, you're just you're traveling the country, kind of going to, like, these weird places and, like, getting in fist fights. It's just a weird game.
Hey, give me back the controller. I want to start the
okay.
level. I feel naked without it.
That's how I felt.
So like. So that generation, I understand his upsetness because he was really into 3D platformers. That's like his favorite genre, and all three of those were like the biggest 3D platformers of the last generation. And then when all three companies moved on to do other stuff. No one was making 3D platformers anymore.
Yeah.
You know, like, Insomniac kept making Ratchet games, but they kind of went downhill.
The shame to me is that they kept making little Ratchet games where it's like, instead of making all those little, like, cash boosters or whatever, like, why didn't you just spend a whole bunch of time on one good Ratchet and Clank game? Like, couldn't you just give us one good full-length game that would, like, kind of revitalize the franchise? Like, now they're trying to reboot it, but are they gonna fucking put the effort they did into the old ones? Like, Ratchet & Clank 3 was the biggest, best one, and why the fuck haven't they topped that?
You don't think she's kind of hot in this outfit in particular?
Dude, I have no attraction to this girl in this game.
I think she's kind of hot.
I don't like her at all.
I love this look, this particular look.
I hate this look so much.
I mean, like, with
her fucking cargo pants and her,
She's like a, like, kind of like Lara Croft, but with smaller tits, like... Like modern Lara Croft.
I don't like blondes, and I don't like tan girls very
like
much.
Blondes.
Blonde
or
can be okay
girls.
With pale skin, but I don't like tan at all.
Blonde and tan is like the hottest possible things that a girl
no.
can be.
No.
Those are like the two.
Those are like
things.
The most generically hot things.
I don't think Jennifer Aniston is attractive at all. So like if you say that, I get you, but
yeah.
I don't think she is that. Like, she does not look like Jennifer Aniston
and
to me.
She has brown eyebrows, which tells me that she dyes her hair blonde, and I don't find that cool at all.
I don't think it's dyed. Look, her hair's, like, really... It's not very blonde. It's, like, a just dirty blonde.
I don't know.
So we abandoned her because she's a reporter and we're criminals. She was just along to, like, you know... I think she was funding this trip.
Should have saw that one coming.
Like, I think she provided the money for us to do that particular, excavation. And then, you know...
I see.
Pirates came after us, and then we just abandoned
it. Then you jumped ship, because fuck it.
Nathan Drake is not a good person.
Yeah, he's an asshole.
Nathan Drake is a complete asshole, piece of shit, bad man. Uh-huh. Who kills a lot of people and commits a lot of crimes.
But he's also... nope. Don't gun anything.
This place is very verdant. It is difficult to...
Does he have redeeming qualities? I don't remember enough of the story to be like, nah, but he's just kind of a dick, I guess.
He looks out for his friends.
You sympathize with him because he's the main character and you're playing him.
Right. No, he's a bastard. That's what, Yahtzee's always complaining about these games, is that he thinks that, that Drake is so unlikable that it's like, why would I ever relate to or want to play as this character?
But then it's nice when you get to see him tortured. The Tomb Raider games are really better, in my opinion.
Well...
Lara Croft is a better character, probably. She's not...
I can't...
She's not shitty.
I don't think she's a... Okay, if we're talking about in the new games, I don't think she is a better character
than
Nathan
Drake. Well, she might be more likable. Less of a bastard.
I don't think she's more likable. Less of a bastard, yes, but that's because she's just like...
Yeah.
Like a nothing, doe-eyed...
That's kind of true.
...little teenage...
She doesn't have,
like,
a lot of personality.
She has no personality.
Never mind.
She had personality in the old games. I get why, like, you know... Because Jesse's a big... Jesse Wood, who hates new Tomb Raider and loves...
Look how dirty he already
got. We've talked about that on a previous show. But he actually loves Uncharted. And, like, I get why he would complain about that change. Because, yeah, Nathan Drake has a lot of personality. He's just a dick.
He's a dick.
He's not a good guy. He murders... He spends most of his time murdering foreigners.
No matter how wet he gets, his hair always swoops up.
Yes. But, like, I find him... entertaining, you know. He's witty, he can survive anything.
Yeah,
he's an asshole. He's got Sully's cool. Sully's just like an old fucking dirtbag.
He at least seems like he's seasoned and knows what he's doing, and like he's probably an asshole for a reason. Like, he's been through this shit
before.
He's
just a greedy dick,
you know?
Like,
yeah.
I mean, they're treasure hunters. They're out for themselves. They are criminals, you know. They're just not good guys. Lara Croft is just like a kid who ends up, you know, in a bad situation and has to
trapped
learn
in some shit.
But like, she doesn't really have any motivation in the plot. I feel like. Then again, I skipped all the cutscenes in Tomb Raider.
Yeah, you did.
I found them insufferable.
You did skip everything. So,
well, because it's like she's A, boring, and B, has a terrible voice. Like, the voice acting is unfucking. Just unbearable.
Just funny, because they spent so much effort on, like, the acting, and, like, the character model is based on the actual girl who was the actress who did all the motion capture and, like, the voice acting.
I'm sure they picked her, like, you know, partly
because she looks
she's
like
hot and
what
looks like
they
too,
wanted,
like,
yeah.
A, like, Lara Croft, you know. Oh, shit. Oh, get off. But, yeah, this game is... Oh, Jesus. What is it trying to make me look at?
It's pointing you over there. It wants you to go that way.
Oh, I gotta smash through something?
What break the rocks.
Okay. Yeah, for once, those are actually gonna be helpful, because we're not paying much attention.
You're not trying to climb the fucking tree. Hit the thing again.
He said it's hollow, let's break through it.
Down there. He wants you to go over there. What are you jumping around on shit for? There's probably, like, collectibles up there or something that you don't have to worry about.
Here, you do this. I'm trying to manage a train of thought.
Like, already can't play, huh?
Well, this is, like a puzzle thing, and, like, you got me... Like, I felt like I was doing fine until it asked me to look at something, and then I was like, wait, what is it making me look at? I don't understand.
That's a good point. Am I shooting this?
No, something? I think you have to knock it over.
Let me go up there, yeah.
You have to take that whole route that I took.
Jump,
I don't know what you're trying to do. It would be white if you could jump on it.
Oh, right.
So yeah, like...
Do, 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 do,
like, this game, when it came out, I really, like, this was the first, like, next-gen game that I played, so, like, I very much drank the Kool-Aid on the whole quote-unquote cinematic thing, you know? Because I was rereading... Can I
direct my camera?
You use the right stick? Like, any
No, I mean,
game?
I like it. It was locked on that ledge.
Yeah. Like, I was rereading a review I wrote of this game, like, in 2008 or 9? Uh-huh. I think it was 2008. I wrote, like, a long-ass review of this game, because I played through it, like, two or three times. I got 100% on it. I was really into it. And,
This is just pointing me wherever I look.
That's what I thought.
I was like, wait.
That's what I thought was happening. There's something hollow that you're supposed to make crumble.
Okay.
The everyone watching this is furious.
Oh
now.
My god, dude, they're probably
people
pissed.
Are probably already like, I'm
they're not
gonna watch this show.
Like a fast run
this is gonna
button
be
or
the
something.
Worst.
Oh, here we go. I can go up this way.
Well, that's how we got up there in the first place.
We're struggling with the first platform we got. Oh, there you go. That looks like something.
I went across that and it fell, remember?
Whatever.
Were you paying any attention when I was playing?
Nah, dude, I zone out. Talk about whatever you're talking about, man.
Dude, you keep cutting me off, so I am having a hard time. Look, shoot that. No, go back. Go back. Go back. Look at the wall. Do you see that hole? Is that what he means by it's hollow? I don't fucking know, dude.
I can punch.
I have no idea what you're meant to do.
Drake smash!
I stopped paying attention for 5 fucking seconds.
I was running through to six
Give
with
me that.
My
I
was.
Think I see a ledge.
Wait, what if you climb down on that and then climb across?
That's what I was about to...
Yeah! Hey, oh! We missed the tutorial prompt.
Oh, shit.
You gotta climb to the side, bro. Yeah! We missed the prompt.
I remember seeing the prompt.
Very
but,
clean.
Yeah,
okay.
I didn't pay attention to it. Didn't read what it says.
That would have been helpful if you read the prompt.
Yes, I'm sure that the entire audience saw the
that
prompts.
That must have been the most infuriating several minutes of this show. That
now you know
ever
why
happened.
Aaron gets shit on all the time. But the thing is, and I get why. This is what everyone says whenever I like defend Aaron and him doing that.
Yeah.
People always say the problem with Aaron is that would have happened and he would have not acknowledged that. He would have been like, this game's fucking retarded. What do I do?
This
know?
Is an intuitive game design.
Right.
Oh, no. Now it's too dark because you made the brightness low.
Which is, I guess, fair, but...
Hey,
well,
flashlight. Whoa, red bats. Okay.
Anyway, what the fuck were we talking about? When
I don't know, man.
I was telling
You're
the story.
Bitching about Uncharted?
Oh, yeah. No, I wrote a review of this like long time ago, and I was praising it specifically for being cinematic. Like, I was all, oh, man, it's a cinematic experience. Because back then, that word didn't have any baggage attached to it. Whereas now, it's got a lot of baggage
I used to like cutscenes in games and stories.
Yeah, I did too.
Like, holy shit.
I
Whoa.
Used to be really into
I used to like the fact that games had stories, and sometimes I still do.
I like
it's
stories,
not inherently
at least
bad.
Not into, like...
I don't like when you can't skip... cutscenes in a game when you're playing it the second time, but like sometimes it's cool.
But this was the first game that I ever played where it was like the acting is like good.
Yeah.
Like all of the not just the voice act, like because they filmed all of this. It's like it's all mocapped and they would like build sound stages and like have them act on the stage, you know, like
it
a green
used to be impressive
stage.
that was a thing.
Yeah. And, like, because I watched all the behind-the-scenes shit for this, and I was like, whoa, they physically acted all of these cutscenes, and, like...
When you used to play Halo
really
2, where a dude will stand in front of you and talk, then it's like, oh, cool.
Right.
Certainly more interesting than playing Half-Life. Where you're
standing
in front of people.
And, I mean, I still give credit to, like, even in a modern game like The Last of Us or something, like, I'm still impressed with the cutscenes. I still think they're well-made and well-directed. I just think that people overpraise that.
Yeah.
Like, I don't think it's a bad thing to have good cutscenes and good acting and high effort stuff. I just think that when people make it out like that makes it a 10 out of 10, then that's where it becomes a problem, you know?
It's really, you know, it has to be an equal quality.
Am I gonna die if I try to jump that?
Shoot the fucking red thing.
Oh, there's a barrel. All right.
But yeah, every element of the game has to be equally good.
Yeah.
and they have to complement each other well.
You know, the story in this game does match what you do. Like, it's a story about a bunch of thieves growing through tombs, and you go through tombs, and...
Yeah.
Am I fucking something up? I don't...
You have to mash...
Okay, I just wasn't mashing it, like, quickly.
Mash triangle.
I remember reading an interesting thing from a person once who was saying that, like,
Let me do that.
It was a review from someone who had, like some kind of illness or something where they couldn't move their fingers that fast. Like, they just, like, physically were incapable.
Uh-huh.
And they were like, you know, I don't understand why they put these moments in games like this in Uncharted and make it like you really have to mash it. He was like, I could do everything else in the game fine, but when it came to that, I'd have to call somebody in and have them help
That's
me, like,
super
into my hospital
sad.
Room, you know? Like, because I can't mash the button that fast. And he was like, all they would have to do is make it so that, like, it's not that fast, you know? Yeah. Just, like, make it like something's normal. Or...
But then it wouldn't be, like, engaging. It wouldn't be, like, intense, you know?
Right.
You're mashing it because you're pulling the thing up. Blow!
Yeah, I mean, I don't mind so much the contextual button press stuff when it's not, like, annoying or pointless. Like in, again, we always bring up Heavy Rain, where it's just, like, you mash a button that has, like, hold X and he'll move his hand towards the door, and it's like, why? That's not what holding X feels like, you know? At least with that, like, I was mashing triangle, and that felt like what I was doing.
You know, I actually like moments like that in this game where, you fucking, there's no way back. Like, it feels like a point of no return and you're going into this place that, you know, a door closed behind you and you have no idea where you're going. You could die in this place and now you're just pushing forward. And they do that without skipping a beat. They're like, oh, we're trapped in this place? Who gives a shit? Let's keep going.
Right.
But it gives you a sense of, like, of progress and almost, like, helplessness on this unfamiliar island, which is something I liked about Dark Souls, the first one, where you couldn't teleport between all the bonfires immediately, because it's like you get so deep and you don't know where you're going, and you're kind of afraid because you don't know the way back, or you feel like the way back is too treacherous. Nice! Yeah, you did a puzzle. I forgot there's puzzles in this game.
All right, next time on Digibros, more Uncharted. Maybe we'll be less stupid.
Yeah, right.